Well, hello there. So, first of all, sorry for the grainy picture. It's like, it is 11 o'clock at night. But, yeah. So, you guys wanted vlogs. You got vlogs. I don't really know what to talk about, but here we go. So, I got a new laptop. Well, new. It's used, but kinda new. It's newer than that HP piece of crap that is resting down there. It certainly is a lot better. It is a Latitude E4300. And it is quite a nice machine. I'm really loving this thing. I mean, it is light. It weighs like 1.5 kilo. It is kind of thin. It's not the thinnest thing in the world, but yeah, it's nice. And it holds the battery life is shit, because this battery is almost dead, as you will be able to tell if I keep this thing pressed. Okay, that's... There we go, as you can see, it's almost dead, when all of these dots are filled up. In the long press, when I do a long press, if all of those lights light up, it means the battery is fucked. And well, as of now, I'm getting like 2 hours of battery life. So that's decent, I guess. Well, it's a 13.3-inch laptop. And the little waves that you see coming down the screen are because it has a BWM LED backlight. It actually is the first laptop with an LED backlight that I've ever had, and holy crap, is it bright. Like, I don't know if it is at like, I mean, of course this thing has auto white balance, but it is like at almost minimum brightness, and it's pretty much as bright as that was on maximum brightness. So yeah, that's quite nice. It also has the light sensor, so when it detects more light in the ambient, it just ramps the brightness up, so you can see it better. And I couldn't be happier with this thing. It cost me 90 euro, shipped from the UK. It got seized. I'm not sure that is the word, but it got stuck in customs for being dangerous materials. I'm guessing they just turned the laptop on and like looked at the internet history and all that, thanks to the new laws that have been passed over there in the UK. Sorry for you folks. But yeah, aside from that, it took like 15 days to arrive. And well, here I've got it. And it is really, really nice. It also has a webcam. And yeah, that is pretty much it. More specs include, it is a Core 2 Duo SP9300, so that is a low voltage CPU, a 25 watt CPU, which is more than enough. It certainly is like a third faster than the Core 2 Duo I was using before. It has a really nice integrated graphics card from Intel. I say really nice because I was used to a 945G. A 945G. In 2016, I was using that. That is, just to put you in perspective, it is the oldest Intel chipset that supports WDDM drivers, aka can run Aero on Windows. What else? It has 3 GB of DDR3 RAM, which I will eventually upgrade. For now, it's quite fine. It has a 120 GB SSD and OCC ARC 100, which it inherited from that laptop. I don't know what else. It has a, I think it's a Broadcom I put in there. I think it's an Intel wireless NIC, BGN, It does dual band, and it is 300 megabit per second on the end side. And well, it does, of course, it is dual band. It does 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. It has a DVD rear writer thingy, which I'm going to replace eventually by a second SSD. I'm gonna put a second SSD in there, because that thing does nothing there. And it has a red track point, which I had laying around some replacement parts for my old T61, rest in peace. And yeah, I had this track point, and it just so happens that when you cut it to size, because it is taller, the IBM track points are taller than Dell's. When you just cut it to size, like so, and you put a little bit of heat shrink tubing around the peg here in the Dell keyboard to make it the size of the IBM track point, you can use an IBM track point just fine. And there's nothing like this dotted dome thingy on ThinkPads. Like, there's literally no texture like this. So yeah, I'm just using that. Well, the screen is 1280 by 800. It's a display, let's just leave it at that. And well, the trackpad is absolutely awful. Not that I care, I don't even use it. And yeah, that's it for the laptop. So, I got asked for mental stuff. No, mental stuff. I don't really talk about that. Well, I do talk about that, kind of. So, in case you guys don't know, I have Asperger's. I really do have it. I'm not just memeing around. I do really have Asperger's. And yeah, mental stuff. That's mental stuff, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I just said that because I'm an attention whore. I don't know. Thing is, yeah, I have Asperger's. I've been to psychiatric institutions. Polite way to call them. They were really hospitals. And I've been there 3 or 4 times. Last time was 3 months ago, maybe 4. Yeah, something like that. And well, yeah, I just spent a month there, and it was comfy, to be honest. It was quite comfy. It was hot outside. We were in the middle of summer. It was like 34, 35 degrees Celsius outside. I don't know how much that is in Fahrenheit. I'm sorry. But yeah, and we in the hospital, we were at comfy 24, 25 degrees Celsius, which was pretty freaking awesome. And I didn't have to do anything. It was just sleeping, eating, and getting medication. So it was quite comfy. Of course, no computers, no telephones, no nothing. At least they let me take my Porta Pros here. My Porta Pros and headphones, of course, and my mini disc player, and they let me get my mini discs there. Weirdly enough, considering I wasn't on suicide watch. I've been on suicide watch like twice. I have been, and it was a very mild suicide watch. It wasn't even remotely what you see at like prisons and all that. It was just very very mild. But I guess I wasn't in suicide watch. Otherwise, they wouldn't have let me take the mini discs inside. But yeah, I was. Thing is, I was comfy. I would just listen to music. I read a ton of books because they just happened to have a little library. And, well, I read The Lord of the Flies. I read a lot of books that I had been willing to read before, but I didn't get really time to. So I read The Lord of the Flies. I read Animal Farm. I read... what else? Journey to the Center of the Earth, I think it's called. And I'm sorry, I just go by the title. That title, I don't really know in English. But I guess it is Journey to the Center of the Earth. Oh, sorry. I also read... Dubliners. Oh my god, Dubliners was a fucking brick. I could not understand a single thing. I read the whole book, and I got nothing out of it. Absolutely nothing. I do not know why people praise that book so much. I got nothing but boredom out of that. But, hey. Whatever. I also read... Wait, how many did I mention? I know I read 5 books. So that was... That was Animal Farm, Dubliners, Journey to the Center of the Earth, Lord of the Flies, and the other one I read was, heck, I cannot remember. Let me try and remember a little bit. As you know, these videos are unedited, so feel free to just... you know, stop the video and do something productive. But, gee, I don't remember what other book I read. Huh. Well, fuck it. So I went to a thrift store, well, 2 thrift stores today, and I picked up some things. I picked up a little point-and-shoot camera, which I didn't have, I only had my SLR. My SLR, by the way, is this little nice thing right here. This is a Konica FS1, and it is a great freaking camera, let me tell you. It is really, really great. Has been taking photos amazingly. Also, this electronics book I got from... a thrift store, cost me 1 euro. It's freaking amazing. Now that I got this one like a month ago, but as you can see, it's from the 60s or so, and it has a lot of theory, and it has something that I've been interested in. Sorry, my English is not the best. Yeah, interested on vacuum tubes, and this thing goes over vacuum tubes in a really, it explains them really, really well. So yeah, I'm finding this book, of course it's in Spanish, I mean, you can't locally get books in English here, but it's quite good anyway. And I picked up, let me see, yeah, my room is full of trash again, but I do sort it all out every now and then. I got this little point-and-shoot camera, it's a Vivitar from the 80s, quite simple, there's absolutely nothing special about it. It's just your typical film, 35mm film, point-and-shoot camera from the 80s. Absolutely nothing special about it. It doesn't even have motor... how do you call this? Motor return? I think it's motor return. But it does have a manual wheel. It does have batteries for the flash, but nothing else. And I've taken a grand total of... 2 pictures with it. Amazing. Well, I picked it up today, so yeah. I just threw in one of these cheapo... Superior Extra ISO 400 rolls of film, and yeah, I mean, for a point-and-shoot camera, it'll do. Well, hey, I it I use them in my SLR too, but yeah. I also got this, my first GameCube game. I don't even have a GameCube, I have a Wii, but I guess I don't even have GameCube controllers, but I can play this with Nintendon't, which is a little compatibility layer, I guess, that allows you to play GameCube games with the classic controller, which is amazing. And, well, yeah, Need for Speed Underground 2. I'm not into tuner cars and all that. I'm not really into that, but hey, it was on Euro, so here it is. First game I have gotten in this little format. And next thing I got this, which is Get to Know Spain, Spanish version. Yeah, and I don't know, I just got it because it was in beta. A freaking beta tape. Yay! I do not have a beta player. But yeah, I hope I can get a beta VCR sometime. And as you can see, the erase tab is not broken. Amazing. I also got this thing, which is way cooler. It is the coolest thing I got today. So I'm gonna save it for later, actually. I also got this little light. Well, it's a fixture for videos and stuff. It has a tripod mount down there. And it has these little flaps. I don't know what they're called. I guess reflectors, maybe? I just cut my freaking fingernails, so I cannot really poke around stuff, but yeah, it is pretty cool. And it has this standard bulb mount for halogen bulbs, which I think there are LED bulbs that can just fit in there, and this thing's just 240 volts. And it's literally just a bulb mount with a switch in the back. There's nothing more to it, but it is quite nice. It has a tripod mount, and yeah, it'll come in handy for low-light videos. And, well, as soon as I get a bulb, that is. And this was 5 euro. This was actually the most expensive thing I bought today. I almost bought a Dell Optiplex GX110. But I didn't, because I already have one right there in the SFF configuration, and the one that was over there in the thrift store was a desktop configuration, but it seems like there is two configurations in the desktop model. One of them has two 5.25-inch bays and 5 PCI slots, and the one that was in the thrift store was the one with was another configuration with only one 5.25-inch drive and 3 PCI slots. So, and it actually had the optional ISA card, which brought the PCI slot number to 2 PCI slots. So yeah, that thing already has 2 PCI slots, so I don't give a fuck about that. And now for the coolest thing I got today. Did I get anything else? Oh, I also got Mischief Makers back from a friend who I lent it to. He beat this thing in like a week. Man, he's freaking amazing at video games. I got this Sony Video Basic MSX, and in case you do not know Spanish, this says IT cores. Sorry, my real-time translation isn't really that great. It's something along the lines of video cores for MSX computers, and Video Basic MSX, and as you can see, it is in beta hi-fi. Impressive. And of course, it is by Sony. It is official from Sony for their Hitbit computers. And look at these guys, look at this family. Damn, they're happy looking at a blank screen, but of course they're looking at a Trinitron, so that makes me happy. That sure makes me happy, so I don't see why they wouldn't be happy. I'm happy staring. I'm staring at a blank Trinitron. Staring at a Trinitron always makes me happy. Unless it's one of those curvy, really black ones from the 90s. Late 90s. Early 90s ones were amazing. But yeah. And yeah, it has contents. I'm not gonna translate this, but yeah. It's just basic. It's a basic course, which I hope I can play sometime, because I want to learn something, and basic would be a good way to start into. I would like to learn some programming, and I feel like basic would be a nice place to start. And well, it's just two beta tapes, and this case can actually hold. I found this really amusing. It can hold Video 2000. For those of you Americans who don't know what Video 2000 is, it's a video format that was kind of successful here in Europe, and it was marketed by Philips as the video compact cassette. And unlike VHS and Beta, you could actually flip the tapes around, so you use it pretty much like a music cassette, and you get double your runtime. But yeah, this case can hold Video 2000 VHS and Beta tapes, all the three of them. That is really, really cool. I found that really, really cool. And as you can see, it has two Beta tapes, which seem to have been recorded over, sadly, because they have sticky tape over the erase hole right there, the erase notch. But they look pretty good. Like they're really hefty tapes. Like I've never felt a VHS tape being as hefty as one of these. They are LS370s, so that's about 1.5 hours in PAL format. And it even says copyrighted program over there. That is real nice. So yeah, I would like, if these have the original content, which I highly doubt, thank you previous owner, if these have the original content, I would like to upload it to YouTube. Thing is, I don't have a beta VCR, but as soon as I get a beta VCR, I'll just get that. And I'll look into recording a little bit of the thrift store where I got this, because it is cyberpunk as fuck. It is seriously cyberpunk. Like, there's just old shit all scattered around. Like, there's VHS-C cameras, two VHS-C cameras. There's, like, 30 VCRs, none of them is VHS, that's why I didn't pick any of them up. There's DVD players, there's old monitors, old keyboards, none of them mechanical. There's two or three beige computers. There's like just old TVs. There's just shit scattered all around, and I literally mean shit. Like, there's nothing of interest. Like, the only thing of interest is this. Was these beta tapes, maybe that VHS-C camera, although it's a very late VHS, well, one of them is a very late VHS-C camera, the other one not so much. The other one is from like 1994, 1996, and the newest one is from 2000 or so. It's actually the same model that I showed in another video, one of those JVC cheapos. And yeah, I don't know what else to say. Yeah, that thing, I'll see if I can record that thing, that place, because it is cool as fuck. They also had a little tray loading tape deck by Grundig. Well, they actually have the entire system, the entire hi-fi system by Grundig, including the turntable. The turntable is so fucking amazing. The turntable, I'd kill for that turntable, seriously. I would kill for that turntable. But the guy over there seems to be very keen on keeping the system, so yeah, it's his as of now, so yeah. Can't really do anything. But yeah, that's about it for the vlog. Hope I've covered all the bases you guys wanted me to. And also, I've noticed I have 59 subscribers. How the heck did I get so many subscribers? Seriously, man. Well, I'll just leave you with this lovely picture. And yeah, see you soon.